When the Pasig River in the Philippines was declared biologically dead, everyone thought there was no longer hope for this body of water. However, when one species of fish was introduced to it, something unexpected happened. For better or worse, this changed the infamous river forever. A government agency came up with what seemed like a clever idea at that time. Introduce a small group of janitor fish into the Pasig River. This species of fish isn't native to the country. Before we continue, can you guess which region this fish is native to? Type your answer in the comment section. If your guess was South America, then you're right. It was brought to the Philippines in the 1990s due to its role in cleaning aquariums. So, hoping that their cleaning habits could help the world's most polluted river back to life, they released these fish into it. Or, so they think. Pasig River. The main river in Metro Manila that connects Laguna de Bay and world-famous Manila Bay. It stretches for about 27 kilometers, with an average width of 91 meters. Since ancient times, rivers were said to be the main catalyst of great civilizations. From the fertile banks of the Nile to the mighty Indus, rivers pumped life into the first human settlements. The said fact can never be truer in the case of the Pasig River. Under Spanish rule, the Pasig River was the very artery of Manila. Its waters carried galleons and barges stacked with rice, sugar, coconuts, and timber. These goods fueled the city's growth. Along its banks rose churches, trading houses, and bustling communities. As a proof of its significance for the survival of the colony, it was called the Queen of Rivers. When the Americans came, they also acknowledged that the Pasig River is vital to promote progress for the country. It powered Manila's rise as one of Asia's most developed cities. Warehouses and factories lined its banks, while ferries crisscrossed its waters. Fast forward to modern times, something happened along the way that made it one of the most polluted bodies of water in the world. As often with the case of nature being sacrificed in favor of progress, the same fate happened to the once beautiful Pasig River. Metro Manila grew rapidly due to urbanization. Along with it was the massive rise of its population, which the megacity wasn't able to handle. These people from the provinces who migrated to the city in hopes of finding better opportunities have built their shanties near the riverbanks and estuaries. Of course, with no proper waste disposal, the river and canals became their instant sewage. On top of that, factories crowded the riverbanks, dumping untreated chemicals directly into the water. Even hospital waste flowed in. By the 1970s, the river had already become a national disgrace. For many, the Pasig River seemed lost forever. But the Philippine government knew it couldn't simply abandon it. The river had long been the lifeblood of Manila, woven into its history for centuries. Hence, in the 1990s, they established the Pasig River Rehabilitation Commission. Their mission was simple: to bring the river back to life. With such a tall order, they've come up with various approaches to achieve their goal. First, they relocated the families living along the riverbanks. After that, the river was dredged and deepened to bring back its natural flow. Easements were cleared of illegal structures and waste disposal was more tightly controlled. To involve the communities in their efforts, they established the River Warriors. These are the volunteers who were dedicated to guarding the river against abuse. But there was one interesting move that experts did to this river that would change it forever: dropping a small group of janitor fish into this body of water. But, you might ask, if this river is so polluted, how were the janitor fish able to survive? Known to science as pterygoplichthys, its speckled armor and razor-sharp spines give it an eerie, almost alien appearance. The janitor fish's ability to survive in polluted, murky waters is rooted in its evolution in the Amazon. In times of extreme drought, when rivers shrank into stagnant pools, oxygen nearly disappeared. To survive, this fish evolved to breathe air. Unlike most fish that rely only on gills, it can rise to the surface, gulp air, and absorb oxygen through the lining of its intestines. That ancient survival skill now gives it an edge in filthy, oxygen-starved waters. In rivers like the Pasig, where pollution feeds swarms of bacteria that strip oxygen from the water, most fish suffocate. But not the janitor fish. This fish wasn't just able to survive, they multiplied with such extraordinary speed. This is something to be expected since they didn't have natural predators. To say that the river has been taken over by this invasive species wouldn't be an overstatement. Anyone who stopped along the banks could spot them easily, clustered in large numbers just beneath the surface. Ironically, rather than cleaning the river, they only made it worse. Their egg-laying habits disturbed the riverbed, stirring up sediment that left the water cloudy. In other words, this invasive species became an unwanted guest in the river that the government had been trying to revive. So, cleaning the river meant not only fighting trash and toxins, but also battling a creature that was never meant to be there in the first place. When the floods tore through the megacity, the true scale of this problem revealed itself. Along the riverbanks, thousands of lifeless janitor fish lay scattered. Those who were trying to go fishing in the river were able to catch janitor fish more than 2 feet in length. Scientists explained that the river's endless pollution kept the fish well fed, contributing to their extraordinary size. So now the question is, how do you solve this challenge with the invasive species? With extraordinary problems comes extraordinary solutions. Local governments along the river began devising their own solutions to confront them. For instance, one LGU launched the Janitor Fish Eradication Drive, which granted cash incentives to participants. Another effort focused on turning the janitor fish into a source of livelihood for poor families living by the river. Because locals refused to eat the janitor fish, although it's safe to consume, experts turned to a different idea. Instead of the meat, they focused on the skin. By carefully removing the flesh and organs, then curing and treating the hide, the janitor fish could be repurposed and shaped into useful products. Examples of such products were coin purses, key holders, and other small items that could be sold for extra income. Meanwhile, some have proposed a more practical approach. They've come to the conclusion that since this fish has already firmly settled in the river, there's no getting rid of it. With that reality, some proposed a new approach. Rather than fight the fish, why not find ways to live with it? For instance, authorities could transform this fish into a mascot. Its strange features printed on t-shirts, school bags, even toys. In this way, the fish would no longer be seen only as a nuisance, but as a reminder of the rivers it inhabits. And through that shift in perspective, people might grow more mindful and protective of those very waters. What about you? Can you think of other ways to put the janitor fish to good use? Let us know your thoughts about this. As always, until the next one.